if I turn his back, it creates some motion, create a scramble, okay? For freestyle Greco Roman, my goal is just to tip him. You're going to hear a lot of times to go to the side of the trapdoor. I'm going to tell you to never go to the side of the trapdoor. If another coach has told you to do that, it doesn't make him wrong and me right. This is just my experience, okay? The coach told you to do it, it doesn't make me wrong and him right. It's my experience. You always go to the side of the head. Anytime you go to the side of the arm, it's a big problem. If Sean is to do this to me, go to the side of the arm, I would love for him to do that. All I have to do is change this angle. If I can change this angle, he's going to be pinned. His arms are now trapped and he's on his back. Anytime you go in a front headlock, now notice again, if Sean does this again, but I stay here and don't change the angle, he's going to roll me right through. Okay? So all I need to know defensively is if I start to get rolled towards the arm, I cut a quick angle on him. I'll show you one more time. He goes towards the arm, I got to change the angle right there. He's not going to get out of that. For me, that's a big problem. Okay, as you guys get older in wrestling, it's a big problem. So you know what? We're always taking the side of the head. But I can go to the side of the arm. And where that becomes relevant is he's got to guess. Even though taking him to the side of the head is wise, he's got to show respect if I fake like I'm going to go to the side of the arm. So he never knows. This guy's playing detective the entire time. And I decide why I'm going to turn him. So when we do this, a front headlock, we want to get exposure. Again, don't forget front headlock. Doesn't matter what style we're going. It's a battle of the elbow. So I got to keep that elbow. If I lose the elbow, I got to get it back. If I lose the elbow, I got to get it back. Whatever I have to do, but I got to have this elbow. I like to take my far arm, bring it all the way through to his face. I'm going to put my thumb on his face. Anywhere. Long as my thumb touches his face, I'm going to grab my hand. My thumb, anywhere, on his face, and I'm going to grab the hand. There's a devastating position. You guys will feel it when you go. Right here. Okay, don't lock this up. I see young wrestlers do this all the time. They do their lock right, and then they move it. Different position. This, can everybody see this? This is a different position than this. They're close, and they look similar. They're totally different positions. I put this thumb on his face, and I lock him in right here. Now all I've got to do is bring my knee up, and I can tip it right here. This is all I have to do for points. I know it's very common to believe you have to roll all the way through, and that is okay. There's not a rule against that. I just want to remind you guys, all I have to do is tip it. Right here. The key on this move, it's very simple, but the key on this move is that my arm, my hand, my thumb comes to his face, and I get my lock. Right here, this is very tight. You guys will feel this when you go, it's very tight. And any resistance he gives me, I'm just going to keep turning. So I bring that knee in, I start to go to my hip, and I'm just looking to tip him. Right there, if he returns to his belly, I'll return with it. If he wants to go all the way through, I'll go all the way through. Right here, now we're in the same position. We're ready to score again. So right now, emphasis, guys, take that far arm, find your lock. Right there, thumb goes to the face, and we lock. Can we do it? Yeah. Go!